And welcome back to another Carboot toy haul. Except this time, it's not actually a Carboot toy haul because it was a private sale. But I'll give you a bit of backstory. So one of my friends, he deals in what's called auto jumble with antique car parts, vintage car parts, and landscape salvage. And he got invited to a private sale at a manor house, and bought a load of stuff off this guy. Said he was going to come back and pick it up, but he noticed that there was a load of vintage sort of toys and computer games, video games. So he asked the fella if they were for sale, and they were. So he said he was going to invite his friend around when he went to pick up the other sort of stuff. And this is what I managed to pick up. It's all near vintage. It was the guy's son who went to university, I think, in like 2006 or something like that. Can't quite remember now. So let's have a quick look. So first up, we have this like N64 bag, and I don't think I'm gonna be able to show it properly. Okay, let's just try like this. Where the hell's the zip? Oh, there. So I haven't tested it out yet. I've managed to plug it in and see the light comes on. But the aerial connection is one that just does not work on my TV. It's got everything with it. It's got a black controller and this rather snazzy gold controller, which I was happy to find. Now, I paid 40 quid for this. I know that's worth 10, 15 pounds on its own. Obviously, we've got the console, assuming that it works. Apparently, this all just got put into a barn 15 years ago, so might have been longer than 15 years. That's just when the guy went to university. We have all these games. A couple of things there. We got WWF No Mercy, Star Wars Rogue Squadron, WWF Warzone, F1 Grand Prix, and best of all, GoldenEye. So I'm hoping this works. I do have the guy's phone number if it doesn't, but we'll see. Now, I've also noticed, I didn't notice at the time, but there is a zip at the front, and we've got some stuff in here. We've got a Turok 2 instruction manual, which sadly we don't have the game for that. 1080 snowboarding, not have the game for that. But this looks cool. The Legend of Zelda Ocarina of Time. I'm not actually sure what this is, but it's an instruction booklet, or whether it's a story. Yeah, it's like a novel. That's really cool. Nice. Is that from 1999? Yes, it's a novel of the game. That's cool. We have the Ocarina of Time instruction manual, but we don't have the game. That's a pity, because that would have been cool. What's that little leaflet there? We also have the Turok 2 Seeds of Evil strategy guide, official strategy guide. That's kind of cool. Next up, we have this bag. This has a whole bunch of stuff. First up, we have this My Organizer for Pocket and Color Game Boy Logic 3, so it's not official Nintendo, but in here we have a Game Boy Color. I've tested that, it is working. There's a game in that now. And the games come with it were one of those pirated games. Oh, Wave Race. And this one that I don't know what that one is, Shadowgate Classic. We paid £10 for that. And it also came with a Game Boy Pocket. We got some Sega Saturn games, Tunnel B1 and Clockwork Knight. I have no way to test them because I don't think I have a Sega Saturn. I might have no game in that. What's in this one? And we have got a game in that, at least. Mostly we got the Mega Drive games, E-Swap, Super Thunderblade, which is one? Mercs. The box ones, we've got MiG-29, Toy Story, which I didn't even know was out. Didn't realise it was released back in... doesn't say. Doesn't say the date on it. But apparently it was the late 90s. Aladdin. NBA Showdown. Mega Games 3. Super WrestleMania. This is one I played a lot on the SNES. Echo of the Dolphin. Another Echo of the Dolphin. Oh, that's the Tides of Time. And lastly, the Menacer pack and the light thing, but no Menacer gun, unfortunately. How many games is that? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 games boxed. 3 games on their own. The Menacer thing and the 2 Saturn games. I played £20. Might have paid a little bit much there, I'm not sure. Depends how much some of these are worth. I know I definitely wanted that one. And I just bought the whole lot, so. There we go. Right, let's move these out of the way and look at the next stuff. So, next up we have the bag, box of Pokemon stuff, which cost me £25. First up, we've got a load of soft toys. I don't think they're anything particularly special. Jigglypuff then, Blastoid. Squirtle. A Charmander. Now these are all the original ones by the looks of it. Late 90s. Possibly early 2000s. Checking the labels, let's see what this one says. Yeah, 2000. So these are all seem to be vintage then. Eevee there. Poliwhirl. Coffin. Onix. Raichu. Mew, Poliwhirl, Butterfree, and another Raichu. Is that the same one? Yeah, same one as the last one. So I think that was probably worth £25 on its own. But then we have a Pikachu money box, which is marked up with Courtney. That must have been his daughter. And his son, Luke. So he must have had two of them. I'm guessing this is not just the sons then. We have this rather cool Squirtle pencil organizer thing. Again, $9.99. That's very cool. We have a Pokeball. I know what this is. It is the. It's supposed to come up automatically. Oh, there we go. Pokeball, little electronic game. Yeah, put it in. Let's see, need to test that, but that's pretty cool. I'll get jammed again there. We have this Jigglypuff Room Guard. And a Charmander Room Guard. I actually have a Pikachu one. We have another money box. This is a talking Pikachu one. Put the coins in there and it speaks to you. Oh, we have another little soft toy of a Slowpoke. We have a whole bunch of little stuff. Oh, that is a Heracross. What date is this then? Well, that's 1999. I don't know, that's just the copyright. A marble with face on. Oh, nice little Tomy. Dratini. Farfetch'd. Mr. Mime, they look, that looks like a fake one. Oh. Gyarados. Little thingy there. I go through a bit quicker. Some absolutely knackered bouncy balls. A bunch of glass marbles. All with a Pokemon on. We've got a Charmander, one of them. Ball rollers. I think this is McDonald's, not baking. A bunch of the little figures. I think most of those are sort of knockoff ones. That one's probably not. A couple little Charmanders there. We have a big pack of cards here. Oh, there's a Digimon. And Digimon ones. Not the actual trading card game, but we got them. A couple of little Pog type things. I think these are from the game that they came with. I think. And lastly, for the Pokemon stuff, we have Pikachu's Vacation book. Kids book and a Pokemon book, which is like a novel of the game. That's pretty cool. Right, let's say £25 was an absolute bargain for that. And lastly, there was the box of Sonic stuff, which I also paid £20 for because it's slightly smaller. It's quite a lot smaller by the looks of it, but still some pretty cool Sonic stuff. We got this absolutely beat up Sonic. I couldn't even tell you how old it is because that's gone, but I'm guessing that's a pretty early one. Put that there. Best probably of the lot, we actually have two of the big electronic talking figures. 2000s, again vintage. Metal crap, big figures these are. Fortunately, lots of sun damage on the knuckles. And I do believe there is the knuckles.
Whoa, that was incredible. I've never seen anything like it. Time to make a house call.
The knuckles actually still works. I mean, the Sonic mod might work, but the battery's still working in the knuckles. And we have this Sonic figure. Game from 2000. We have a Tails figure with like a wind-up tail. Oh, we're setting that off because it'll be annoying. We have a Sonic piggy bank. Now, that brand is from they make chocolate advent calendars and the little chocolate egg sort of things. I'm guessing it's from like an Easter gift box thing. We got a Big Cat. I think he's supposed to have his fishing rod or something, not too sure. We randomly have Mario from the movie. I don't know if I have Mario or not. I know I have one of them. It's either Mario or Luigi, and I can never remember which. We have Sonic from Burger King, I think. Or maybe it's not from Burger King, I don't know. I seem to think it was from Burger King. That's from 1999. And the Knuckles. I'm sure these are from Burger King or McDonald's or something. And lastly, we have three of these Game Boy like keyring things. I don't know if they actually say what games they are. Oh, they say in the back, there we go. Mario's FC. That's something to do with Factory, Cola Factory or something. Donkey Kong Jr. And Super Mario Brothers. 1998, so that's pretty cool. So how much did we pay for all this? 25, 45. So altogether it should have been £115, and I got him down to £100 to round it up nicely. And we'll just take back and see what we've actually got. So we got all the Mega Drive games, Game Boy Pocket, the N64, and a bunch of games. We have this whole box of Sonic stuff and Pokemon stuff, so I'm pretty happy with that. So hopefully it won't be so long until the next Carboot Toy Haul. So we've definitely been picking up a lot of stuff. Obviously, since lockdown, I guess people have been tidying out their attics and garages and stuff. So until then, ta-ra for now.